Now we have already discussed about belt conveyor. The next thing what we are going to discuss, that is the chain conveyor. Okay, after belt conveyor there is chain conveyor. Now the term chain conveyor, that means a group of different types of conveyor used in diverse application, characteristics by one or multiple strands of endless chain which travels the entire conveyor part, driven by one or set of sprockets at one end and supported by one or set of sprockets at the other end. Now materials that to be conveyed and carried directly on the links of the chain or on specially designed elements is attached to the chain, and the load carrying chain is generally a support supported on the idle sprockets or guide weights. Okay, and this endless chain, they are kept taut by the suitable chain tensioning device at the non-driven end. Now the basic general characteristics, if you say different type of chain conveyor, they are used in wide varieties of application. Therefore, it is not possible to have a set of common characteristics for all of these, but the chain which is compared to a belt conveyor have a certain advantage as well as disadvantages also. The major advantage of chain conveyor, the major advantage of chain conveyor is these chain are easily wrapped around by sprockets of small diameter, and the drive is very positive, that is no slippage can take place between the chain and sprocket. So number one is, there is no slip between chain and sprocket. Okay, so it is a very important thing for any kind of belt conveyor. Now this chain stretch is also little in portion. And the disadvantage of basically, so number two, we have to write down chain stretch is little. Okay, and the basic disadvantage of chain is that is number one, high weight. The weight is very high due to the metallic sprockets and chains. And another one, number two, that is the highly initial cost. Okay, so basically these two is the very important part. So due to high weight and high initial cost, their maintenance cost will be higher, and most importantly, intensive wear at high speed may occur, and maximum length and maximum lift of the chain conveyor, they are also limited by the maximum allowable working tension of the chain which is being used. Now different type of chain conveyor is available. So types of chain conveyor, number one is apron or pan conveyor. Now in case of apron or pan conveyor, it is a very common type of chain conveyor, and which consists one of the more one or more strands of endless steel, usually link plate roller type. Okay, and it running through the steel guides. Rollers of the conveyor, they carry the entire load of the materials and chain. So the roller is a very important for this apron or pan conveyor. Now the carrying surface of the conveyor is composed of a serial plates or shapes called apron, which is attached to the links of chains through the cleats. And when the conveyor aprons have vertical fangs on all the sides from a pan like shape, it is specifically known as the pan conveyor. And their application is basically this type of pan or apron conveyor perform severe duties of conveying large quantities of bulk load such as coal, ore, slag, rock, then foundry strand. So there are different uses of this type of pan conveyor. Specially designed aprons are also used for conveying the unit loads, coils, hot forgings, like of material things, which is very heated throughout the system. Okay. Again, part of an apron conveyor may be run through a liquid or water bath for washing the materials, and again then allow the drainage of liquid from wet materials. Apron conveyor, they can also have a flexible layout to follow combined horizontal and inclined movement at the same vertical plane. Now, in case of designing, there are flat or spaced apron. So, in case of designing, there are flat or spaced apron, where specifically that is called slat conveyor. Okay, splatter, spaced apron conveyor, that is slat conveyor. Then again, there is corrugated apron conveyor. Okay, they have some different uses, and another is special type apron conveyor. Then there is crossbar or arm conveyor. Crossbar or arm conveyor. Now this type of conveyor, they are named by different special arm conveyor. They are named by different type of names, like pendant conveyor, pocket conveyor, wire mesh deck conveyor, removable crossbar conveyor, fixed bar conveyor. So there are different names, and basically these crossbar conveyors, they are used for conveying and elevating or lowering unit loads like barrels, drums, rolls, bags, like these of things. These conveyors may be loaded or unloaded manually at automatic loading or discharging stations. Okay, now these crossbar conveyors are also used in a wide range of process applications such as dripping, washing, spraying, like these of things. Then there is cart type of conveyor. Cart type of conveyor. Now this cart type of conveyor, this consists a serial series of small platform cart types of thing, which is pulled by an endless chain running through a closed track. Okay, this is also called as carousel conveyor or pallet type conveyor, and this is driven through a vertical axis, and this track is placed more or less than in a horizontal plane, and this car may be either permanently switched to the driving chain or may be propelled by pusher dogs or chain or ropes. Okay, the basically this type of conveyors particularly used for carrying heavy or irregular shape type of conveyor. Then number four, there is carrier chain and flat top conveyor. Basically this type of conveyor is divided into two parts. One is the rolling type of carrier conveyors, where the chains are provided with rollers moving on tracks for minimum friction, and the materials, they are supported on the attachment. Okay, and there is another is sliding type of carrier chain conveyor. Then there is flat top chain conveyor. Now, in case of flat top chain conveyor, it is a particular group of carrier chain conveyors which may be rolling or sliding type, with specially designed chain links with flat plate attached to the chain links, so that it can provide a continuous smooth level top surface to carry small articles like bottles, cans, like this of thing. Then there is trolley conveyor. Now this trolley conveyor, they consist of a series of trolleys supported from an overloaded endless track and overhead endless track and propelled by an endless chain or cable with the loads usually suspended from the trolleys. Okay, so this type of conveyor is also two types. One is load carrying trolley conveyor and another is load propelling trolley conveyor. There is another type of trolley conveyor which is load drawing trolley conveyor. So there are different type of trolley conveyors is available, and another type of conveyor is available, that is power and freak conveyors. So basically special design of load propelling or pusher trolley conveyors. These are the one type of special chain conveyors which is available in the market. There are different type of conveyors is also available, like space suspended tray conveyor or swing tray conveyor. They are also part of this chain conveyor. The next thing what we need to learn, that is the components of a chain conveyor. So it is very important to understand what are the main components of a certain chain conveyor. So basically the main components includes, number one, that is the pulling chain. Now this pulling chain, they can be round link chains which are low in cost and high flexibility in all direction, and having flexibility which is particularly desirable in case of trolley conveyors. However, there is some kind of limitation of this chain is available, that is it has a less contact area, high stretch under load and a rapid wear available. Now then another one is available for this pulling chain, that is the combination chain. Now in case of these combination chains, they are widely used in many different conveyors, and these links are generally cast mailable iron construction with machined steel pins are available, and maybe with or without roller this is available. So this is a very better step for rather than of this round link chain for the pulling chain which is used for a chain conveyor. Okay, then another type of pulling chain is available, that is link plate chains. So link plate chains, they are also called as leaf chains. They are mostly common type and used in chain conveyors, and this link plate, they allow different type of attachment to be fitted in the chain. And when the construction is going on of this type of link plate chain, it may be the bushless chain without or with roller, and the boost chain with or without roller are basically used to decrease the wear at the link joints. This type of roller, they are also fitted with the bushes or any type of anti-friction bearing or large size of chain. And this type of link plate chains, they generally run on the guided track or throughs which carry the entire weight of the chain load bearing, and it reduces the pull in the chain. Because of this advantage, chain with boost and roller, they are the preferred one amongst all. Okay, number two of the component, that is the sprocket. Now these sprockets, they are made of good grade cast iron with chilled hardened teeth or from cast steel or plate steel. Now the teeth are machined to shoot type of chain. Okay, the advantage of using this large sized of sprocket with greater number of teeth is to obtain smoother operation. Then number three, that is the take up arrangement. Now this take up arrangement, it is basically the common type is the adjusting screw type. For positioning the bearing blocks supporting the teacup sprocket shaft, the range of the adjustment should be sufficient to permit the initial slack off of the conveyor chains for joining of two links to make them endless and ample adjustment for initial stretch and subsequent wear or elongation. Now the alternative design is also counterweight type, which provides the automatic constant tension in the chain. Now the next one is the drive arrangement. So it is very important for any type of belt conveyor or chain conveyor, the drive arrangement is played, drive arrangement played the most important part. So drive for a conveyor generally consists of an electrical motor, what you know, which is coupled to a speed reduction gear unit, which in turn is coupled to the driving sprocket. For a conveyor having simple configuration like apron conveyor, the drive is located at the sprocket at the end of the loaded strands of the chain. And for other type of conveyor like trolley conveyor, tray conveyor, cart type of conveyor, which having a complicated path of motion, the drive is located for that type of conveyor. Drive is located in such a place which is determined by the analysis of tension variation in the path of the conveyor motion. Okay, drive may be fixed or variable speed, and a crawler drive is employed for giving drive a straight portion of pulling chain. Now the straight portion of the conveyor chain is supported by the set of supporting roller, which is driven by the dogs of the drive chain. And the last one, that is the frame structure. Now this frame structure, it supports the entire conveyor chain guide rails or truss, scart plates or other component which are commonly associated with the chain conveyor. So frame structure, it plays a very important role in case of all other components in chain conveyor. Frame structures, they are generally custom designed to suit the location of the, it is done to suit the location of the chain conveyor. Okay, and their application also. The frames that may be floor supported, set below the floor, or it can be hung from the roof, or it can be bracketed from the wall or columns as required by defined type of conveyor, where the place of the conveyor, you have to check the place of the conveyor, then you have to design the frame structure along with that. Now different type of chain conveyors may need other type of special components and structural arrangements which must be mentioned into the design, and by depending on that you have to calculate the structure and you have to load the frame in such a way so that each and every attachment can be associated with the chain conveyor.